Hello and welcome to S channel friends. My name is Aditya and in today's vlog we are going to install the PostgreSQL database server on our Android phones.
But why?
Okay, so I understand that these database instances should be running on servers that can provide high IO or where high concurrency is required. But I can think of some instances, for example, when I was upgrading my PostgreSQL 11 servers to PostgreSQL 13, I was able to explore a lot of new PostgreSQL 13 features on my Android phone while I was commuting to the office. Maybe you could also try out some new Postgres stuff from the blocks directly on your Android phone, or you could use it for, let's say, understanding big queries or debugging them, or for fiddling just with the PostgreSQL settings and seeing what happens when you change them.
So that's enough for now.
Okay, so let's begin with the PostgreSQL installation. But before we install the PostgreSQL database server on our Android phone, we need to install this Termux application, which is a Linux terminal emulator. In simple words, it basically creates a Linux-like environment on your Android phone, using which you can not only just install a database, but do a lot of other stuff, like for example, hosting a website or programming in Python or Golang and a lot of other stuff you can't even imagine. And you can do all of this without rooting your Android phone. So in order to install this Termux app, you need to go to the Google Play Store and download it from there. But again, I would recommend here to go to the Termux application website and download the APK from there and install it, because it is much more updated version compared to the Google Play Store one. I think they are also going to remove this app from the Play Store because Play Store is restricting kind of some developments in that app. So once you have this Termux application installed, just open it and you get this Linux shell where you can type apt install PostgreSQL, and this will install the PostgreSQL database server on your Android phone. So it might ask you for a confirmation, just type Y and press enter. And once you have that installed, you can start the database server. But before we start that database server, we need a directory where we can store our database contents and a lot of other PostgreSQL setting files. So technically you should be creating this directory inside this path, but for the sake of simplicity in this tutorial, I'm going to create this directory inside my current path where I am right now. So let's create this directory mkdir space postgres. And now you need to initialize this directory using this command initdb space the path of the directory, and that should initialize the directory. And you can see already a lot of things are going on related to PostgreSQL. And if you ls into this directory, you can find a lot of files that you would be familiar with if you have already used PostgreSQL on an x86 machine. So now that we have an initialized directory, to start the PostgreSQL database server, you have to type this command pg underscore ctl space dash d for directory, capital D, and then the path of the directory, and then start. And that should start your PostgreSQL database server. You can check if it has been started by running this command ps space aux, and that should show you all the processes that are running inside this Termux shell on your Android phone. And you can see a bunch of PostgreSQL processes that you would be familiar with if you have ever seen a PostgreSQL instance running on an x86 machine again. And now that you have started this PostgreSQL server, you can now create databases and users from the command line itself. So let's create a database real quick. You can type this command create db space the name of the database. Let's create the hello database for now. So create db space hello, and that creates the database for us. And now you can optionally also create a user using this command. I'm going to skip it for now, and we are directly going to log into the PostgreSQL shell. So in order to log into the PostgreSQL shell, you have to type this command psql space dash d for the database name, and let's add the database name that we just created, which is hello, and that should allow us into the PostgreSQL shell connected to the hello database. You can list out all the databases using the slash l command, and let's just switch to non-tabular format using slash x. And now if you do slash l, you can see basically all the databases including the Postgres database. And you can also list out a lot of settings from the Postgres database, like for example, we can write this query select name comma settings from pg underscore settings. Let's limit it to 3. Don't forget the semicolon. And once you press enter, you can see a few settings from this table. And you can do a lot of other things like creating your own databases, tables, and running a lot of other queries that you would run on a normal x86 machine running a PostgreSQL server. So now let's exit out of the shell, and I'm going to show you how to stop the database. So you have to type this command pg underscore ctl space dash capital D. And the name of the directory which we initialized in the beginning, and stop. And that should stop the database for you. You can check it using ps aux again, and you can see basically the processes are now gone, and you can actually create aliases for all these commands. So all the commands that I've typed so far and all the instructions, I'm going to compile them into a cheat sheet, and I'm going to put the link to that cheat sheet in the description below. So make sure you check it out. And that's all for this video, guys. If you liked my video, do hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more such interesting videos. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.